Hi, everyone. It's me, Krylios, Team Rayceen Productions, MC and producer. And today I have with me a wonderful special guest, the one, the only songbird and songstress, Ms. Nia Simmons. Welcome.
Oh, I love that welcome. Thank you so much for having me. Always great to see you.
Always great to see you. Always great to see you. And thank you so much for joining us here today. It's such a pleasure to have you here. And, you know, first of all, I want to get a little bit into your background when it comes to singing, when it comes to music. Let's get a little bit into that, and then we'll dive into more topics, especially your relation with Team Rayceen.
Okay. Well, what can I say about me? Born and raised in the DMV area, specifically Virginia, Alexandria is where I was born and raised. Been singing since I can remember, starting in the church like a lot of us vocalists did. Fast forward to college, ended up at Howard University, and had the honor of being one of the, founding members of the jazz choir Afro Blue, which has gone on to do plenty of amazing things, win a whole bunch of awards. I'm so very proud of them and the work that Professor Miller continues to do with them. Since graduation, still doing the music thing, performing around the DMV area. Actually, started my journey as an independent artist in 2012, 2013, released my first single, which did really well. A few other singles came after that, and then the album. Finally got the album done in 2015, which was just a huge feat. I'd never done anything like that before, but thank goodness, got it done. It was well received. Thank you to all who have supported it. And of course, it's still available for sale, niasimmons.com and other places digitally. But since then, that opened opportunities for me to actually do a European tour that same year, and also some collaborations with other independent artists. So there's other music out there as well, in addition to the album that has been released since then. And yeah, just continuing Wonderful. The singing and performing. Yeah,
I love it. I love it. Such a journey, and such a wonderful journey. And, you know, it's been such a pleasure and such an honor and such a blessing that, you know, here at Team Rayceen, we have had that opportunity to, you know, work with you, to be in contact with you, to have you, you know, be a part of us. And I mean, you know, what really launched our online platform right now, the Tell Rayceen YouTube series, and you were on one of those first early episodes. At the start of 2020, you were with Rayceen for that episode. Tell me about that episode. How was that for you?
Oh, just the whole online thing has just been interesting. And
yes.
It's been an adjustment, but the more you do it, I guess the better that you get at it.
Yes.
And it's always a fun time with Rayceen and Team Rayceen. Everybody's just been very supportive of me and my career just from the get-go. And I'm always appreciative and always honored to participate.
Love it.
It's all the time.
Yes, I love it. I love it. And you know, you mentioned that your first album, you know, dropped in 2015, and that's also the first year you performed at the Ask Rayceen show, and you performed the next year and the year after that and the year after that one. And the other year after that one. And of course, you were scheduled again to perform in 2020 at the Ask Rayceen show this year. And you know, 2020 has been very, very unprecedented. But you know, anything can happen. Anything can happen.
Yes. So yeah, y'all can't get rid of me now. So
I love it. I love it. I love it.
Year after year after year. And it's absolutely my pleasure and honor that they keep having me back because I always enjoy myself. Yeah.
Yes, I love it. And, you know, we look forward to 2021, you know, where we can continue this beautiful partnership with, you know, for anything new or anything old or anything continuing that Team Rayceen may be doing and that you may be doing, you know, we look forward to really being involved with that and, you know, really getting into that. You also performed the Artomatic 2017. Yep. I remember that very, very well. I think that was probably the first time I saw you perform because I wasn't with Team Rayceen yet in 15 or 16 when you had performed. But I co-hosted at Artomatic 2017 and you performed there. And since we've been doing this online stuff, you've been to our first Wednesday show, I think in August, was it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you've had a long and storied career with Team Rayceen, with collaborating with Team Rayceen. So it's always so great, you know, to have you and to have you just give us your art, you know, to have this platform where we can display your art. It's always great to do that. Thank you so much for, you know, being a part of this.
My pleasure. Team Rayceen has definitely kept me busy in 2020, and I loved every minute of it because honestly, when everything went down, I really didn't know what I was going to do. I had gigs getting canceled or postponed, understandably so, but we still have the online platform to take advantage of and utilize. And Czar, shout out to Czar.
Yes.
He just always thinks of me, and I'm always very appreciative to get that call, get that text, hey, can you participate in this event? And absolutely been my pleasure to do so.
How have you really taken 2020 and, you know, tried to turn it on its head? How have you managed this year, you know, when it comes to, you know, your personal life as well as your career? Because I know for everyone, as the year started and everything, you know, started happening, it was a lot of whiplash, you know, and people really had to take, you know, some time to kind of find their footing in these overused phrase, but yes, in these uncharted waters of 2020. Right. How has that been for you?
Well, it took a while, but eventually I was able to channel this free time I had. Let's just be real. I had a lot of free time due to everything that was going on. So I channeled that time and that energy into my creative side and just got back to writing, back to recording and getting ready to release some new music in 2021. No excuses. I needed the time to do it prior to everything that happened. Now I have it. Let's work. Let's go, you know?
Of course. Speaking of 2021, what are you looking forward to for 2021? What are your hopes for 2021? And what do you have on the horizon?
My hope for 21 is to get back on the stage, to get back to the Ask Rayceen show, performing for all the wonderful folks that support that show, that platform, to get the album done finally, because the first album came out, like I said, in 2015, so it's time for some new stuff.
Yes.
From me, so.
Tell me, yeah. Speaking of the new album, how have you been inspired musically this year, and what are you leaning into story-wise and musically-wise when it comes to the songs and the album that you're looking forward to?
Just whatever feels good. I'm just into really that feel-good music of the days of past. I guess it would be old school R&B. I hate using that term because it makes me feel old. Good music is just good
music. Good music, yes.
I really just gravitate a lot to the sounds of the 70s, 80s, even some of the 90s too. Mm-hmm. But you get a little bit of everything. I even kind of delve over into the jazz side as well. Yes. So it's just whatever feels good, whatever I just like. That is cool what I like. I don't really totally stay strictly into one genre per se. If I'm feeling it, I'll record it, I'll sing it.
I love it. I love it.
Hopefully people dig it.
Yes, yes. And speaking of, you know, people digging it, let's plug some stuff. Let us plug some stuff. Let's plug your music, merchandise, all of that. How can people, you know, support you, buy your stuff, listen to your music, follow you, and keep up with what you're doing?
All right, well, the main hub is the website, www.niasimmons.com. That's NIASIMMONS.com. And then you can also find my music pretty much anywhere, digitally, iTunes, Amazon, everything. And just keep up with me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter is at Nia the Songbird. So yeah, just stay connected and hopefully you'll join on this journey with me through music, especially in 2021 is going to be the year. I'm claiming it. No excuses. I'm doing the work now.
Yes. I'm doing the
work right now, so I'll be ready. So
it needs to be that year. And after this year, after 2020, 2021 needs to be that kind of year. A resurgence, a renaissance. That's what we're looking for. Thank you so much, Nia, for joining me today.
My pleasure. Thank you so much.
Of course, of course. Always so great chatting with you. And to our viewers, thank you for watching.